Obviously, first of all, I would like to thank you for the honor and the privilege of for being here. I think it's a great opportunity for us to showcase what we're doing from on behalf of Hilton Worldwide globally. I oversee a graduate recruitment, and that's in the bigger terminology, and it's part of the youth institution that we definitely work with. And part of it is that when we started off, you know, working on the biggest strategies and just following some words, we felt the urgent needs that institutions, the working field, and a governmental institution had to combine forces to work on doing that. And I would just like to show you a quick video to see what we were doing, and I'll continue on that.
Demographic in the world today, more than one quarter of the world's population, but 75 million are unemployed. By 2020, the travel and tourism industry is expected to generate 73 million new jobs. As the fastest growing global hospitality company, Hilton Worldwide recognizes that investing in our future workforce meets both business and societal needs. We are partnering with the International Youth Foundation to build an action plan for our industry and turn the youth unemployment challenge into a global opportunity. Download the white paper to learn more.
So this white paper was launched in the year 2013, and that was actually the starting point, if you from us to continue, where in the year 2014, our CEO and President, Christopher J. Nassetta, announced during the World Economic Forum in Davos that we would open our doors to a million young people around the world. And that was our open door pledge by the year of 2019. And by doing that, we will take it on three kind of categories. Initially, by connecting them to our industry, to provide them the opportunity to meet people from the industry and to learn what kind of opportunities what really out there. Secondly, is about preparing them to understand what an industry, you know, like us can mean for them socially, but also in terms of educational purposes and how we can actually can introduce them. And finally, and that's obviously a big plus, is about employing them. And that's the main thing what we're going by. And there's a number of initiatives that we run throughout the company, and it started, one example, in the United Kingdom, back in the year 2010, where there was one person who thought that we needed to do something more. And she launched the Careers at Hilton Life. Catherine Porter happens to be now our leader when it comes to youth employment across Europe, Middle East, and Africa states. And that initiative in the UK became a European initiative a year after and became a global initiative now. Whereas every year in the month of May, we spend time with all the properties around the world, owned, leased, managed, and franchised properties, to spend and see how can we make sure that young people on the local level, because we feel this is a global initiative, but we need to take this locally, can understand what kind of opportunities are really out there. That's run simultaneously with another event that was called Bright Blue Futures, which was one of the main brands that we operate in, Hilton Hotels and Resorts, felt that all our team members were finding donating some time and expertise with young people to learn them and educate them more, to see what kind of opportunities are really out there. And other brands were following and going. So all our 13 brands have something specific here. It goes without saying that we have many opportunities in terms of apprenticeships and internships opportunities, and we do a lot of them with La Roche, and I think La Roche is one of our leader industries that we collaborate with already for many, many years in these kinds. We're very proud of continuing doing that. But we felt that obviously we need to touch base of many universities across the state, and today we work in my region with 340 plus universities and colleges, and that we are able to expand more and more while we grow. It also goes with professional development programs, and I think the last part, what we do with a very successful one, is the Passport to Success, which is part of the life and soft skills trainings. Because that skills gap is something that we initially had as well. We know that the waiter job, when we got in this hotel 30 years ago, was conceived as a big profession. And today, if you get into the universities like La Roche, etc., it's very hard to sell that this is a career profession and that people can grow quickly through the ranks. But we do realize that when it comes to them in your introduction, that we are looking for close to 100,000 team members in the upcoming 5 years, purely in Europe, Middle East, and Africa. We've got a great task and a great responsibility at hand. So there's many things that we try to push this by. So on all levels of youth, we try to make sure that we are a great employer and that we're a great industry to go by. What we do specifically here in Spain, what we do specifically here in Madrid, is the HOPE a project that had started in the Hilton Madrid Airport, and Isabel, our Director of HR, is here to join us today. So if you've got any questions, she's more than able to do that. It is specifically for us to tackle the issues with disadvantaged people with a disadvantaged background and say, you know, we can offer you a great opportunity to work in our industry. Not necessarily to work within Hilton, but we would like you to train you during a period of 4 months of time on various elements through our departments and see, is this your future business of choice? Is it something you can relate yourself with? Is it something you can grow into? And it has been very successful. And I think that success, that blueprint, has been picked up by JB Morgan, and we've grown this, obviously with Binardi, which is our social partner, our political partner, and we've grown this to a multiple number of projects running through the country. One of the many things that we're doing, and I think obviously we'll have all these questions afterwards.
Thank you very much.